Hi guys, this is the fourth video of the video series Normalization. In the first video, we understood what is normalization. The second video on first normal form demonstrated the removal of multivalued attributes. And in the second normal form, we discussed that there should not be any partial dependency of non-prime attributes on a portion of the primary key. If you have not watched these videos, I will drop a link to them in the description, and I advise that you watch them as well. Now in this video, we are going to talk about third normal form, which has two basic rules. The dataset should be in second normal form, and non-prime attributes should only depend on the candidate key and should not have any transitive dependency on non-candidate key columns. You know how I like to do it? Let's understand this with a practical example. This table displays the winner of major tennis tournaments for the last 3 years along with the country they belong to. The candidate key or primary key for this dataset is tournaments and years. Now, player's country, instead of solely depending on the primary key, is also dependent on the player's name, which is in violation of third normal form since player is not part of the candidate key. So as the definition says, the dataset should be in second normal form, which is the case. Non-prime attributes player and player's country are not dependent on a portion of the primary key, but this dataset is not in third normal form because player's country is dependent on a column other than the candidate key. In order to bring this into the third normal form, we are going to break this dataset into two subsets like below. The first dataset has the same candidate key, but now it is not in violation of third normal form. The second dataset has player name as the primary key, and it also complies to third normal form. So let's do a quick recap. A dataset is in third normal form if it is in second normal form and all the non-prime attributes are solely dependent on the candidate key. In this video series, we are going to cover 5 more topics. BCNF, which is a slightly stronger version of third normal form, will also be covered, and that needs a clear understanding of candidate and super keys. So we will discuss that in our next video. We will practice real examples of normalization and normal forms, which are usually asked in assessments, or they will also help you in modeling your dataset. We will take that in a separate video. We will also talk about denormalization and why it's done. And in the final video, we are going to talk about OLAP and OLTP, their differences, and how they use denormalization and normalization for storing data effectively. I hope today's video was helpful. Thanks a lot guys for watching this video, and I will see you in the next one.